Joining us now is Sheriff Bebue. Sheriff, good to have you on, my friend.
Laura, thanks for having me on. I appreciate it.
And look, you're 20 years Army National Guard. You serve this, your state proudly as sheriff. You serve the country proudly. But this situation with this Obama executive order, now essentially we've made it official. We're not deporting anybody. I mean, he says it's 5 million people, but the goal here is basically, from everything I can gather, to have generally a porous border and let the people pick up the difference as far as costs and so forth.
That's true. In fact, now we have the evidence of it. The same day, on the 20th, this past Thursday, when the president was giving his speech, Jay Johnson, the Secretary of Homeland Security, released a six-page memo. We just released it this morning, basically instructing all federal agents and officers that they will not enforce immigration law. And
wow.
It goes into great detail talking about prosecutorial discretion and saying only if that the priority is if they committed murder, rape, any of these serious violent felonies, that's the priority. And it essentially gives a pass to the 20 million illegals who are here. So it's not 5 million. And as much as I feared, because the president had said that if they were here 5 years or more, they're eligible for this deferment. Well, in fact, my first concern was, oh my God, the black market for developing all these fraudulent documents, which we all know identity theft is the number one crime in the country, is very easy. $50, $100, you can get these lease agreements or utility bills fraudulent in order to satisfy the president's requirement. But now this memo by his Secretary of Homeland Security basically instructs ICE, you're not going to be arresting anybody anymore. And that's the reality of the situation, is that the president should have put America and our citizens, our country first for once, and secured the border, and then looked to do something along the lines of if this is his agenda. But he didn't put us first. He put people from a foreign country who disrespected our law, disrespected our process, and now they're going to be all eligible lawfully, not just for Social Security cards, work permits, welfare, and housing.
Oh, they're going to be voting. I mean, if you don't think a lot of these people are going to be voting, then, I mean, what turnip truck did you just fall off of? I mean, these people are going to be voting. They're going to be getting all the benefits. The president said, well, they're not getting the benefits of citizenship. Which ones aren't they getting? I think that was
exactly.
All a lie. Get right with the law. No, the law is you're not supposed to be here. Getting right with the law is leaving the country. That's getting right with the law. You're not getting right with the law. The president is the one who needs to get right with the law. He's the
Absolutely.
One who needs to get right with the law, not the people who are here illegally. They're already afoul of the law.
Well, and this is what it does. We all know the rule of law, what it serves as. There's consequences for lawbreakers, which do two things. They serve as a deterrent, and they also provide justice in our legal system, usually for victims. The president, in one fell swoop, took both of those main components away for people from outside our country who are here. And that undermines the essence of who we are as a republic. And that we cannot tolerate. And so the damage he's done there, and then the incentive for the millions and millions of illegals who have yet to come here, what it says to them is there's no enforcement of law. And people shouldn't be scratching their heads wondering why my deputies, when we're arresting illegals here for state crimes, that they freely admit they've been deported 10 times. 14 times, 16 times, because there's no consequence. There is no law when it comes to immigration.
Well, right now, DHS is apparently drunk drivers, sex abusers, drug dealers, gun offenders are not the top deportation priorities, according to that memo that you're referring to.
Correct.
So all of those individuals can stay in the country.
And they have been. They've released, right in my county, Pinell County, Arizona, released close to 500 criminals that were on their way to deportation this past year. Two of them were charged with murder, multiple convictions for child molestation, aggravated assault, armed robbery. All these, they just released them to the streets. And they refused to give me the names of these individuals. And whistleblowers gave me this information. Then it was later confirmed after the media browbeat the administration into admitting it. And they won't give me this information because we can then connect Jose or Miguel or whoever it is that commits an additional crime, oh, this is the guy that's on this list that was released by Obama.
Oh, yeah, they don't want it coming out. They don't want the information coming out. We find the same problems, by the way, Sheriff Bebue, with tracking a lot of the crime blotters across the country. We track a lot of these new arrests for all sorts of things, child rape, horrific crimes against spouses, domestic abuse, drunk drivers, and oftentimes you can't get the information of their immigration status. They're just keeping people in the dark about a lot of this because they know if the public knew the full extent of the illegality by hundreds of thousands of illegal immigrants who are here, beyond just the crossing the border illegally, document fraud, violent crime, drunken driving, narcotics trafficking, crimes against children, people would be truly demanding that the laws are enforced and deportation be fast-tracked, but they don't want that information out. So I think a lot of this is keeping the ball, hiding the ball from the public.
You're right. In fact, the release from prison has already started. This weekend, I got a call from ICE officials here, and it's happening around the country. So everybody thought it was just the 20 million illegals who were here. We'll just let them, as the president said, continue to work, continue to be held by their grandmothers in their arms. Well, it come to find out, they started releasing. They released up to 50 right here in my county. How many in Phoenix, I don't know. But all across the country, they're releasing them from prison that meet the president's basic amnesty by his executive order.
So you're certain that this is happening, that the releases of what, illegal aliens who committed these lesser offenses?
It's absolutely confirmed. Other incidents have been through whistleblowers. This is an actual high-ranking official from ICE who called me on Friday and said, Sheriff, I'm just letting you know, so you hear it from us, that we're releasing 50 in your county this weekend. And I was like, wait a minute. I thought it was the president was talking. I should have known better. But he said, no. He goes, any of that meet this criteria for prosecutorial discretion, it says right in this memo, you're to stop lawful action against them, any court cases against them. It has this whole list of criteria by the Secretary of Homeland Security about what they're to do in order to preserve their resources.
Are these just individuals who are in violation of immigration law or immigration law plus another offense who are released?
Plus many other offenses.
Oh.
And these are convictions for crimes here in the United States. These were supposed to be the 24,000 of the 20 million that even President Obama said should be deported. The worst of the worst. And they were on their way out of the country, and they were just released. If I did that this weekend, if I just had a mass prison break out of my jail, what would you do to me?
Yeah.
You wouldn't fire me. You'd arrest me.
Arrest you. Yeah, you'd be an accomplice.